Bonjour, bonsoir, guten Abend aus Graz. Heute in einem rein französischen Duell beim zweiten Spiel der B-Gruppe. Das Frankreich aus Europa spielt gegen das Frankreich in Nordamerika, genannt auch Kanada. Die Kanadier zum ersten Mal dabei bei einer Weltmeisterschaft, haben bisher nur zugeschaut und das ist doch ein wenig verwunderlich. Canadian Football unterscheidet sich von American Football in einigen wesentlichen Punkten. Zum einen mal die Anzahl der Downs, es wird in Kanada nur 3 Downs gespielt. Das Feld, die Länge ist 120 Yards plus längere Endzone noch, also um die 150 Yards lang. Und es sind 12 Mann am Feld. Ansonsten ist der Sport mehr oder weniger der gleiche. Die Kanadier hier einer der Geheimfavoriten und Frankreich eher einer der Außenseiter hier. Wir schreiten bereits hier zu den Hymnen. Oh Canada, die Nationalhymne von Kanada, gefolgt jetzt von der französischen Hymne. Das war die Marseillaise, ein blutiges Liedchen, Nationalhymne der Franzosen. Auf Kinder des Vaterlands, der Tag des Ruhms ist da. Gegen uns wurde der Tyrannei blutiges Banner erhoben. Hör im Land das Brüllen der grausamen Krieger. Sie rücken uns auf den Leib, eure Söhne, eure Ehefrauen zu Köpfen. Ich finde, das ist eine Nationalhymne, die einmal richtig Pfeffer hat. Da fließt Blut. Das wollen wir jetzt zwar im Spiel nicht sehen, aber ein bisschen Pfeffer im Football schadet nie. Die Fans hier, es wurde heute eine offizielle Zuschauerzahl, eine zahlende Zuschauerzahl bekannt gegeben. 6.500 sind im der UPC Arena und zum ersten Mal seit langer Zeit, muss ich sagen, das kommt mir ein bisschen weniger an die Angaben, allerdings bezieht sich das ausschließlich auf die verkauften Tickets. Das heißt, da werden noch gut mal 1000 Leute mehr herinnen gewesen sein. war beim Österreich-Spiel gut gefüllt. Wir haben uns gefragt, wie viele Leute werden wohl zu diesem Kanada-Frankreich-Spiel da bleiben. Ich kann es vorwegnehmen, es sind sehr viele. Heißt, die Leute sind nicht nur wegen Österreich hier, sondern auch wegen der WM, wegen Football. Und man weiß ja nicht, was man sich bei diesem Spiel erwarten kann. Kanada, ein unbeschriebenes Blatt, es gibt keine Videos, es wurde kaum gescoutet. Ja, man weiß eigentlich gar nicht, was passieren wird. Coach Rhodes ist natürlich da und auch der komplette Coaching-Staff vom Team Österreich. Und die haben gesagt, nach der Pressekonferenz, nach der Niederlage jetzt gegen Japan, sie werden sich in diesem Spiel wahrscheinlich viel mehr Aufschlüsse auf das Ganze bekommen wie bisher und sind sehr gespannt, was ihnen die Kanadier hier bieten werden und natürlich auch, was die Franzosen drauf haben. Denn eins darf man nicht vergessen, wir sagen immer, ja, Frankreich, die schlagen wir sowieso. Die muss man erstmal schlagen. So ist es dann auch nicht. Es sind jetzt nicht so wie der französische Meister mit 25 Mann in Tirol da, sondern hier mit 45 Spielern. Und da sind einige Herren dabei, die NFL-Europe-Erfahrung haben. Und an einem guten Tag können die auch Österreich knacken, so ist das nicht. Also die sind definitiv eine Spur stärker als Schweden. Auch voriges Jahr gegen Schweden gewonnen, zwar nur knapp, aber trotzdem gewonnen. Und da muss man aufpassen, wenn man sagt, naja, um Platz 5 spielen wir für alle Fälle, weil Frankreich, die packen wir schon. Das muss erst gewonnen werden. Aber vielleicht sehe ich das zu negativ und wir gewinnen gegen Frankreich und gegen die Kanadier. Bin sehr gespannt, was wir da jetzt von dieser Mannschaft sehen. Ja, der Coin Toss ist erfolgt. Kanada hat den Coin Toss gewonnen und wird den Ball in Empfang nehmen, die Franzosen damit in der zweiten Halbzeit als erste im Ballbesitz dann. Blattsprecher hat jetzt gewechselt, vorhin war Michael Hollup, jetzt Stadionsprecher Roland Horn gemeinsam mit Robert Seger. Kicker auf Seiten Frankreichs ist Bruno Nekili von Flash de la Courneuve. Am Return stehen. Wow, die Nummern von den Kanadiern, da braucht man Adleraugen. Die sind rot auf weiß und die Sonne steht tief. Und ich glaube, es ist die 87, die am Return steht. Kannst du die Nummern von den Returnern erkennen, Christoph? Ja, du hast einen Feldstecher mit. Ja, 87 hätte ich auch getippt, nur einen 87er habe ich nicht am Roster. 35? Interessant. David Stevens am Return und der andere 87er. Ja, zu den Klängen von Thin Lizzy wird hier der Kickoff erfolgen. The Boys are back in town. Wird, das sehe ich jetzt schon, einige Probleme bekommen, die Nummern der Kanadier zu erkennen. Weiße Jerseys, rote Nummern drauf und die glänzen in der Sonne. Ich sehe eigentlich nur rote Flecken. Auch mit Christoph Wagners Feldstecher ist es nicht zu erkennen, sehr originell. Also gut gemacht von den Kanadiern, man weiß nie, wer den Ball hat. Kickoff ist erfolgt durch Frankreich hier im Spiel, im zweiten B-Gruppenspiel gegen Kanada. Nummer 82, jetzt sehe ich ihn am Return. Das ist Jet Gardiner und der kommt nicht weit an die 15 circa zurück. Gardiner von der University of Guelph. Da kommt auch ein Spieler her, den ich gut kenne. Bei den Black Lions letztes Jahr gespielt. Davor bei den Gladiators. Wenn mir jetzt der Name einfiel, dann könnte ich Ihnen noch verraten. Ja, Mike Doherty war das natürlich, der auch von Guelph kommt. Erster Play von den Kanadiern, ein kurzer Pass auf die Nummer 84. Pass war für 3-4 Yards, 2.6 Kanada. Quarterback ist die Nummer 3, Michael Faltz von der University of Western Ontario. Übergibt den Ball auf den Running Back. Oh, der ist schnell. Da ist ein wahnsinnig schneller Mann unterwegs. Starke Moves von der Nummer 35, glaube ich, war das. David Stevens. University of Saskatchewan. Ja, da gibt es eine Flag. Und das Flag geht noch zusätzlich dazu gegen die Franzosen. Nice First Down für Kanada an der 32-33 Yard Linie. Kanadier stellen sich mit. Ja, interessante Formation, das ist eine Art Wishbone, diese da eine T-Formation, Single Wing. Jetzt stellen da öfters um, Quarterback wirft tief, inkomplett überworfen. Weit überworfen die Nummer 86, Scott Wahlberg. Zweiter und 10, wieder ein Pass, diesmal komplett, wieder auf die Nummer 84 geworfen. Shamot Chambers von der Wilfrid Laurier University. Kurz nach dem Snap. Pass komplett auf die Nummer 80. Jamek Murray, aber da gibt es eine Flag gegen die Franzosen. Offside Defense und das First Down damit Realität für Kanada. First Down für die Kanadier an der eigenen 43, 44 Yard Linie. Quarterback Michael Faltz in der Shotgun Formation jetzt. Nummer 39 geht in Motion. Und Play Action Fake und da geht der Quarterback selbst. Und ist unterwegs Richtung Endzone. Das ist der erste Score in dem Spiel durch den Quarterback der Kanadier, Michael Faltz, mit einem Lauf über exakt 56, 54 Yards. 6:0 für Kanada vor dem Extrapunktkick. Thanks for Extra Punkt ist ebenfalls gut. 7:0 für Kanada. Also, die Kanadier schließen ihren ersten Drive gleich mit dem ersten Touchdown und einen gültigen Extrapunkt ab. 7:0 der Spielstand. Noch 9 Minuten 59 im ersten Quarter zu spielen und wir werden jetzt zum ersten Mal die französische Offense am Feld sehen. Außer wir sehen einen, natürlich jetzt einen Onside-Kick. Bei den Kanadiern ist die Nummer 5. Ein Herr, der im Nachnamen Hairuluha heißt. Unglaublicher Nachname. Lirim Hairuluhu. University of Western Oregon, Ontario. Bist du narrisch? Das sind Namen. Kickoff geht durch die Endzone. Touchback. Jetzt werde ich ein bisschen üben. Lirim, der Vorname ist mir mal klar. Der Nachname ist, ich buchstabiere es mal, für zu Hause zum Aufschreiben. Vielleicht kann dann jemand es nachsprechen. H wie Hans, A wie Anton, J wie Josef, R wie Richard, U wie Ulrich, Doppel-L wie Lisbeth, A wie Anton, H wie Hans und U wie Ulrich. Harulahu. Originell. Das ist ein Tonguebreaker. Da hätte man sich vorher den Pronunciation Guide durchlesen müssen, den gibt es natürlich nur in der NFL. Erster Versuch für Frankreich, Running Back Nummer 28 ist auf dem Weg durch die Mitte für mehr oder weniger 0 Yards, Laurent Marcelin war das von Flash de la Conneuve. Jetzt hätte ich gern an meiner Seite Nicolas Martin von GFL Radio. Der könnte mir sicherlich bei der Aussprache seiner französischen Kollegen helfen. Nicolas ist ja ein Franzose, geboren in Frankreich. Glaube ich, irgendwo in Malta hat er noch Verwandte und ist in Deutschland zu Hause und macht dort mit gemeinsam mit Tasso Melzer das GFL Radio. Incomplete Pass hier, gedacht auf die Nummer 22, Dimitri Kierna. Von den Black Panthers Tonon-Lepin. Bitte entschuldigen Sie mein Französisch. Nein, ich versuche gerade, Christoph schaut mich entgeistert an, ich versuche gerade Französisch zu sprechen, beziehungsweise den Namen auszusprechen. Tut mir bei manchen leicht, bei manchen weniger leicht. Dritter Versuch und 8 für Frankreich. Quarterback ist bei Ihnen Nummer 13, Max Breuel von den Black Panthers. Pass complete jetzt, geht sich knapp nicht aus für einen First Down. Geworfen auf den zweiten Quarterback, Paul Durand von den Spartiates Damien. Bin mir sicher, Nicolas Martin hört jetzt zu und lacht sich gerade einen Ast darüber, wie ich die Herren ausspreche. Es liegt aber eine Flag am Feld. Offside gegen Kanada. Der Downmarker bewegt sich allerdings in die falsche Richtung. Dritter und 3 damit nur mehr für die Franzosen. Max Breuel in der Shotgun wirft komplett. Aber da ist, glaube ich, nichts mit einem First Down. Die Nummer 12 steht nominell auch auf als Quarterback da. Am Roster Paul Durand fängt den Ball zwar, aber das ist sich nicht ausgegangen für ein First Down für Frankreich. Damit kommt die Punt Formation aufs Feld. Nummer 1 steht auch als Quarterback oben. Ball Presala Till von den Centaurios de Grenoble. Punt ist unterwegs, geht an die 40, nimmt einen Bad Bounce, da hat ihn den Kanadier berührt, aber Kanada kann den Ball sichern, oder wer? Der Ball sprang einen Kanadier an und die Franzosen haben den Punt recovered. Großartig für Frankreich. Also unverhofft kommt auf, der nimmt der Ball einen Bad Bounce, springt den kanadischen Spieler in den Rücken und von dort prallt er wieder ab und dann gab es ein Gerangel um das Ei und die Franzosen haben es gesichert. Und damit bleiben sie im Ballbesitz und haben einen First Down an der 37 von Kanada. So kann aus einem Bad Bounce bei einem Punt ein sehr guter Bounce werden für die puntende Mannschaft. First Down Frankreich an der 37 von Kanada. Sproul mit dem Pass incomplete. Oh, der sah incomplete aus für den Mann mit der Nummer 18. Jeremy Rabot von Rouge et Or de Laval hat den Ball sichern können. Übrigens, der spielt in Kanada und zwar bei Rouge et Or de Laval. Das ist, glaube ich, auch der kanadische Rekordmeister. Ballübergabe auf den Running Back Nummer 22, ein spektakulärer Move und Sprung hinten nach von Dimitri Kianon. Black Panthers Spieler auch. Damit haben die Franzosen einen dritten Versuch und nur mehr 2 Yards zu gehen. Ja, die französische Mannschaft nimmt hier ihr Herz in die Hand, sie haben hier nichts zu verlieren. Ihr Ziel ist es, offiziell laut ihrem Head Coach Larry Legault, das beste europäische Team zu werden. Damit müssten sie Österreich schlagen. Dritter und noch 3 Yards zu gehen. Ballübergabe auf die Nummer 28. Geht sich das für ein First Down aus? Könnte knapp werden. Laurent Marcelin war das von Flash de la Conneuf. First Down Frankreich. First Down, Snap ist erfolgt, tiefer Pass und das ist eine Pass Interference, aber der Catch ist made, es muss ein Touchdown für Frankreich sein, trotz einer Pass Interference, die vorangegangen ist. Touchdown Frankreich, sensationeller Pass von Max Sproul. Nur auf wen? Der Mann verschwindet sofort in der Team Area, zeigt uns nicht mehr seinen Rücken. Es war die Nummer 8, die den Ball gefangen hat. Anthony Doble von Grenoble. Touchdown Frankreich. Franzosen nutzen diesen Punt und den gute Ballposition, Feldposition aus und scoren, kommen auf 6-7 ran und die Nummer 15 Bruno Nekili, Panther und Kicker von Flash de la Conneuf, wird den Extrapunkt jetzt ausführen. Der ist getippt, aber gut. 7-7, Ausgleich hier. Alles offen im ersten Viertel zwischen Frankreich und Kanada. Das kommt etwas überraschend, denn noch immer vielen Zuschauern hier im Stadion Liebenau. Heute UPC Arena, vormals auch Arnold Schwarzenegger Stadion, wird hier einiges geboten. Mehrheitlich, wenn ich das richtig verstanden habe, sind die Leute hier im Lager Kanadas. Das ist wahrscheinlich der Eishockey-Effekt. Kanadas Eishockey-Team in Österreich ja sehr beliebt. 7:7, Kickoff Frankreich durch Bruno Nekili. Kick ist in der Luft und wird aufgenommen von einem Kanadier und der nimmt jetzt Fahrt auf, wird aber gestoppt. An der 30-Yard-Linie wird die Nummer 82 von Kanada zu Boden gebracht. Das ist Jet Gardiner. First down, Kanada an der eigenen 30. 7:7, 5 Minuten 54 noch zu spielen im ersten Quarter. Marco Falls mit einem tiefen Pass. Incomplete. Auch hier hätte eine Flag fallen können wegen Pass Interference. Gibt's aber keine. Schiedsrichter lassen hier zum zweiten Mal schon Gnade vor Rechter gehen. Na gut, vorhin war es egal. Es war ein Touchdown, aber das wäre doch eine Interference gewesen an der Nummer 8. Anthony Dablé, der den Touchdown gemacht hat. Und auch hier jetzt. So, jetzt mal an der Kippe. Zu einer Interference auf jeden Fall. Kurzer Pass auf die rechte Seite auf Jamek Murray. Laufversuch am Fumble, aber recovered von den Kanadiern. Der kommt zu einem vierten Versuch für Kanada. Es wird hier wirklich richtig interessant. Fourth down Kanada und damit kommt die Punt Formation aufs Feld. Da gibt es eine Flag vorm Punt. Kein Flag gegen Frankreich. Wäre eine Substitution Infraction gewesen, aber es hat der Coach vorher ein Timeout angesagt. Daher keine Strafe. Timeout Frankreich. Jetzt der Punt der Kanadier, der geht sensationellerweise out of bounds an der 3-Yard-Linie. Entschuldigung, das war die 8-Yard-Linie. First and 10, Frankreich. Lauf durch die Mitte über 4 Yards. Zweiter und 6 für Frankreich, wieder ein Lauf. Kein Raumgewinn jetzt. Wir kommen zu einem dritten und 6 für Frankreich. Dritter und 6, Snap ist erfolgt. Sproul auf der Flucht. Under pressure and makes the first down for France. As we found out that many people actually found out where we are able to watch, or where they were able to watch us, we maybe decide to bring some information to you also in English, because I don't think that so many guys in Canada and France are speaking German. First and 10, France. Rush through the middle, no gain. Nothing there for the French. Okay, they spotted for a yard and a half now. Second and 8.5. And you just switched on. The last minutes, it's 7-7 here between France and Canada in the UPC Arena in Graz. Complete pass from Sproul to the numbers 12, and it's a first down and 10 yards more for France. And it was Paul Durand who made the catch for the French. Surprising game in the first quarter. Both teams scored once, and Canada is actually the favorite here. France only the underdog, but looks good right now. First down France at their own 45-yard line. Quarterback Sproul in the shotgun, and there's an early flag. Offside from the defense, and it's first and 5 for Canada. Max Borrell gives the ball to his running back, number 22, Dimitri Quignon, and he rushes from on the left side for about 4 yards. Should be a second down and just one to go. And so it is. Canada struggled with his offense in the second drive. They couldn't find a rhythm. And they had bad luck when a punt from France take a bounce, a bad bounce, and hit a player from Canada. And France recovered the ball and then went for a touchdown. Complete pass from Max Brail to his number 22 again, Dimitri Karnov, for another first down, Team Frost. But there is again a flag, and it's in the backfield. It's the backfield of the French. Christoph is trying to say something, said it's roughing to passer against number 90, Adriano Belli from the Toronto Argonauts. And it's a huge first down for the French now. The ball will be placed on the 20-yard line. Team France again in the red zone of the Maple Leafs. So as I can see, we have 250 viewers now at the moment. My name is Walter Reiter. Actually, we are doing this for Football Austria. I think you found out how to watch us without being a Football Austria member. Anyway, welcome to our show. We don't stream this here with cameras. We just have a webcam here on, which is all we have. And you can listen to me as my English is like an Englishman speaking in as a German man speaking in Austria English. I don't know. It's not my mother language, as you might find out. Hope you enjoy this. The first quarter is over. It's 7-all after 12 minutes. And France is on their way to put another points on the scoreboard. They're on the 20-yard line of Canada. First and 10, France quarterback Max Brail in the shotgun. Bad snap, and he's under pressure, and he tries to throw away the ball, but it's an incomplete pass. The sign of the referee is incomplete pass, so it's a second down and 10 to go. Second and 10, Sproel in the shotgun, pass in the end zone, but there is no receiver there. And this is always a problem if you throw the pass where nobody is, because then it's incomplete, and it brings us a third and 10 to go. On the 20-yard line, the French are in field goal position. Should be a 36-yard field goal attempt. But still there is one down to play before the fourth down. It's third and 10 French for the French, and to come up with four receivers. One man in the backfield, and Sproel is going to pass the ball. Outside, incomplete, and that should be a pass interference, guys, down there. It's another pass interference where I can't see any flag. The receiver didn't touch the ball and was tackled before. I don't think that was a good decision by the referees. Okay, it brings us a fourth down and 10. And as it looks like, the French are going for the field goal. Bruno Nekili, and it's a 37-yard field goal attempt. Ball is in the air, and it's good. The French take the lead with a field goal, 10-7. What a surprise here. That looks like, yeah, it smells like an upset in the air, because Canada can't find any rhythm with their offense right now. They scored with the first drive, but then something really went wrong for Canada, and now the French are in the lead with 3 points. That's nobody. That's something nobody here really expected, because we all thought the Canadians will be one of the favorites for gold here, or at least silver, because the USA, no doubt about that, are the big favorite here in Austria at the fourth IFAF World Championships. And we saw it yesterday when they played the Outback guys from Australia, 61-0. It was a clear statement that they are going to defend their title here. Let's look if somebody can stop them. Kickoff, France number 15, Bruno Nekili, and the kickoff is in the end zone. And there is guy who caught the ball, takes a knee, and so it's a touchback. Number 82 decided to make no return. Jet Gardiner. And so Canada will start at their own 20-yard line. 11 minutes, 41 seconds still to go in this second quarter. First half, France is leading 10-7 against Canada. I didn't expect me to say that at this moment. We had one game before. Austria played vice world champion Japan, and they lost. The Austrians lost 6-24. First play is a pass, and it's complete on the outside for 5 yards to number 86, Scott Wahlberg from Queen's University. So we have some stats from the first quarter. We're coming to that when there is a break here. We have a second down and 5, Canada. Running back number 33 takes the ball, breaks a tackle, makes a first down. 33 is Matt Walters, University of Calgary. First down, Canada at their own 35-yard line. Empty backfield. Now there is a guy in the backfield. 33 is coming to quarterback. Michael Falls, and 33 takes the ball and makes another first down for Canada. Matt Walters, 2 carries and 2 first downs for Walters now. New first down, fresh set of downs for the Canadians at their own 46. Play action fake. And now we have a pick. We have a pick. Number 26 from the French team picks quarterback Michael Faults. And 26 is Alexandre Maquinon. Spatian Diamio, player, defensive back, makes an interception. And we have a turnover, and the French are leading here. And what a surprise. They have the ball again at their own 31-yard line. So quick stats from the first quarter. We have 3 first downs for Canada, 6 for France, 71 rushing yards for Canada, 26 for France, 21 passing yards for Canada, 66 for France. Yo. So Canada is really struggling here with a well-adjusted French team. First down for French was run through the middle for 5 yards. We have a second and five now here. We have a crazy motion from the left side to the right and back from number one. And there is, again, the pass into Nirvana, as we say here in Austria. There is no receiver there. I don't know what quarterback Sproel is seeing or anticipating there. But there is no receiver for the second time there where he throws the ball. On the other hand, there is also no defender there. So the danger of getting intercepted is zero. Brings us a third down and still five to go for the French. Dimitri Kena in the backfield, but there is a pitch to number four, but Canada really saw this coming, and number 99 makes the early tackle. Michael Jean-Louis for a loss of 2 yards, so it brings up a fourth down and seven to go, and the French have to punt the ball away. Number one punts, and we will see a return from Canada. Number 21, very quick, but number seven, the French team is there to stop him. Aurélien Forgeau stops Troy Adams before worse is happening, and Canada will start at their own 40-yard line with their next offensive drive. Will be interesting if they have adjusted their offense, because they really were struggling with it. Didn't find any rhythm, and between passing and rushing game, there was, huge difference in the effort. And now we have a complete screen pass on number 80, and he breaks the tackle, and he's up and away for a first down and a couple of yards more. Jamik Murray catches the screen and rushes for a first down to the France 40-yard line. Fresh set of downs for Canada in the half of the Frenchmen. Michael Foltz gets the ball, and again a screen pass. This time it's number 84, and he's on his way to the end zone, and this is not a touchdown. He stepped on the sideline, but it's still Shamot Jambers was the man who did it. But it's still a first down on the 10-yard line after French. And with screen passes, Team Canada suddenly finds a way to makes their offense run, and we have number 33, and he's in the end zone. A 10-yard rush by the running back Matt Walters. Touchdown, Team Canada. And the Canadians take the lead over France 13-7 before the extra point attempt. Extra point is good. The guy which I really can't spell, I can spell his first name, it's Lirim. His second name is Haruluhai. I never saw so many things happen here that confused me as much as this second name. It's an H, it's an A, it's an G, it's an R, it's an U, it's a double L, A-H-U. Hai Shrul Lahu. Oh man, this breaks my tongue. I call him Lirim, if that's okay with him. So Canada again in front. 14 to 10 the lead for the Maple Leafs. 7 minutes and 52 seconds still to play in the second quarter of the first half. Kickoff number 5. His name is Leary. And we have a return here by French guy number 1. This is Paul Bressalatil. And he returns the ball to his own 30-yard line. So the French take over the ball at the 30. Quarterback Sproel in the shotgun formation. Complete pass, quick pass to number 17. He breaks the tackle and another one. And he's got a new first down. Correction, it's number 47 for the French. This is César Hibel. First down for the French. With his quick slant pass underneath. Cross on their own 44-yard line. First and 10 for the French. Snap and incomplete pass. Hit the ground before receiver number 47. César Hibel had it in his hands. So that brings us second down and 10 to go. There's an early flag before, after the ball was snapped. Brings up a second down and 15 to go for the Canadians. And again, we have a flag shortly after the ball was snapped. It was a holding against France. Number 74, Jean-Philippe Elder, brings up a second down and 25 to go. Quick pass, but it's deflected. Deflected by Canada. And it's a third down and 25 to go. Max Sproel, quarterback of the French, is really upset now what his offensive line is doing. At the moment, they snap the ball, the bucket collapses, and Yeah. All the defensive linemen are around him, and so he had to pass really quick, and the ball was deflected and almost intercepted by number 95 of the Canadian team, Jake Thomas. We have a third down and 25 yards to go for France. Shovel pass to number 28. But there is no way for a first down. Correction, it was number 22 who caught the shovel. Dimitri Kinnar. But we have a fourth down and 20 yards to go. So the French have to punt the ball away once again. 6 minutes, 30 seconds still to go in this first half. Canada leads with 14-10. The bad punt by number one. Ball Presa-Latil just for about 25, 26 yards out of bounds. The Canadians take the ball over at their own 44-yard line. And the Canadian machine is slowly, but it is starting to run. First and 10, Canada. Michael falls in the shotgun, but the ball takes once again number 35, David Stevens, and he's on his way and still on his feet, and he's up to the French 30-yard line. Huge run for David Stevens from the University of Saskatchewan. And we have a fresh set of downs for Canada on the 30-yard line of France. In a shotgun formation with a play action, and it's a complete pass to Scott Wahlberg for, I guess, another first down. Yeah, they spot the ball close to the lollipop. It's a first down for Canada at the 18-yard line of France. Short screen pass to number 18. An early stop by number 48. Kevin DeMichel. No gain there. Second and 10, Canada. Shotgun formation. Michael Falls is going to pass once again, and pass is caught by David Stevens for a gain of 6 yards. Spot is for 5 yards. It's third down and five to go. David Stevens in the backfield, and he gets the ball from his quarterback again, and there is a flag. The play is for no gain, and there are two flags on the field. Both of them in the backfield of Canada. So this could be another holding. So the referees are talking to Team France. It looks like it's a penalty against Canada, so they should decline it, and it brings a fourth down. It's a holding. No, they take the penalty, and so it's a third down once again. I think that's a coaching mistake, because if you decline it, brings up a fourth down and five to go, and so they have to kick the ball. Take the field goal.
Aber Field Goal Distanz
Third and 15 to go now for Canada. False passing underneath through the middle, complete for a first and goal, Canada. Receiver was Shamat Jambers, Wilfrid Laurier University. That brings a first and goal for Canada. I told him, decline the penalty, take the fourth down, let them kick a field goal. Now I think they will get another 6 points on the scoreboard. First and goal, Canada on the French 3-yard line, but there is again a flag parade shortly after the snap, and it looks like a false start. And a false start, it is once again number 61, Matt Norman, moved early from the University of Western Ontario. First and goal, Canada on at a 10-yard line now. Pass is again complete, and now we have another touchdown for Canada. Number 39 catches the ball. Michel-Pierre Bonprion, Université Laval. 6 points for Team Canada. It's 20-10 before the extra point. So as I can see, we still have new viewers and new listeners here. Please excuse my English. I switched from German into English now because I just found out many people from Canada are maybe listening to this. This is not my mother language, and I'm not doing this all the time. I actually doing this never, ever. I did this once before, and I actually commentate in German, and I hope you can understand what I'm chatting here. Brabber, brabber. Ah, I think you can understand it, huh? Three minutes and 20 seconds left in the second quarter. Kika Lirim, which second name I'm not going to say once again. Ball is in the air and the extra point is good. 21-10, the lead for Canada. After they struggled in the first quarter with the offense, now they really made the turnaround. And this is more what we expected from Team Canada here than that we saw in the first quarter. As you maybe were not here, the French take the lead here with 10-7. But now Canada scored twice and the French didn't have any answer for that. Canada is ready for a kickoff, but Team France is not here. Now they're coming here. I should say it's not my native language. It's not my native language. We have a kickoff and we have a return by number one of the French team, Paul Bresson-Latil, but he stopped early once again. And the French will start with their offense on their own 25-yard line. French decided to rush the ball with the first attempt, and it's for a loss of 3 yards, so it brings up a second down and 13. Still to go. Second down and 13 to go. Incomplete pass for France. Third and 13. Down and 13 to go, and again we have a pass from Max Braille, which makes me speechless, because there was no receiver there where he threw the ball. Looks like sometimes the receiver core and the quarterback are not on the same page after playbook, because it's the third time that Braille passes the ball in an area where no player is. Anybody has an answer to that? I think it's just that they are not on the same page. So the French have to punt the ball away. Punt is on his way, and we'll see a return from the 40. Number 21 is on his way, Troy Adams, and he stopped at the 46, 47 yard line. This looks very good now for Team Canada. The early beginning of this game, this looks like the French maybe can upset here everybody. But now everything is in order for Team Canada. 21-10 the lead, 2 minutes and 14 seconds to go in the first half. Quarterback falls in the shotgun position, takes the ball and decides to roll out on the left side, and we have a pass, and it's tipped and it's complete. That was lucky, but the catch is made by number 86, Scott Wahlberg, and it was tipped before by a French player. So it could easily also have been an interception, but it was a complete catch for a first down. Team Canada on the 40-yard line of Team France. Another pass, this one goes deep into the end zone, and there's no catch. Good defense by French number 3, Honor Vidalier. Second down and 10, and still 1 minute and 50 seconds to go in the first half. Second and 10, Michael Faltz in the shotgun, quick pass underneath, complete for a first down. This time it was David Stevens who made the catch. And the clock starts to run at 1 minute and 44 seconds to go, with a new first down for Canada at the 29-yard line of Team France. Number 35 takes the ball and gets stopped immediately. And there is a late flag coming up, and two players are fighting here, number 61 of Canada and seems like we should bring up a unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. Just wonder against whom. Whitecap is speaking to us. Yeah, personal foul, unnecessary roughness against France, half the distance to the goal line. That is silly, dear French. Can't do that in this situation because there's still 82 seconds to go and Canada is suddenly in the red zone of the France team. Exactly on the 16-yard line after this personal foul penalty. And we have a flag, an early flag, after the snap was made, maybe again a false start. And the false start, it is number 86, Scott Wahlberg. But still enough time for Canada to put points on the scoreboard. 55 seconds still to go. Clock is starting to run now. Quarterback has the ball and completes the pass under pressure, but it's not good for a first down. Shy to 2 yards shy to a first down, and so the clock is still ticking, and Team Canada has to take timeout. It's the first team timeout, so they still have two left. Oh, we have a pronunciation guide here provided by Michael Preston. He says the kicker of Team Canada is spelled Lirin Hairoleho. Hairoleho. Okay, I got this one. Thanks, Michael. But I think I prefer to call him Lirin. Because I don't think that I can remember the spell after a minute. Second down and two to go for Canada's 42 seconds still to go. 21-10 the lead for the Canadian Maple Leafs. Number 35 takes the ball, tries to take it in the end zone, but there is no way. But it looks like a first down for Canada. Could be a first down, good enough. David Stevens on the carry. And the first down it is. It's first and goal, Team Canada. And they spot the ball on the 5 yard line. And it's another timeout for Team Canada, of course. 32.9 seconds still to go. 21-10. The lead for Canada. Matt Walters is on the field. He's... Whoa! We had a motion here by number 80, but he was anticipated and brought down for a loss. Number 80 is Jamik Murray. And now they lost yardage. They're on the 20-yard line suddenly after this broken play. Last attempt and... No, it's not the last one. The stadium speaker is talking crap. I'm sorry, because he said it's the last attempt. There's still six seconds to go, and this was an incomplete pass. And with 6 seconds to go, the Canadians will bring up their kicking team. Christoph, can you show me again what Michael wrote, how this guy is spelled? Lirim Hairoleho is on the field, number 5, with a field goal attempt. And the French take a timeout before the extra point attempt to freeze the kicker here. Seems like they watch the NFL. Guess if you freeze the kicker for the second time, is it unsportsmanlike conduct? No, it's not. This is just what the Washington Redskins always do. They suck. I'm sorry. So the stadium speaker is wondering why they took a timeout while the kicker was trying to make the field goal. Well, I think I know it. So, after they have frozen Lirim once, he's going to try to kick another 3 points for his team again. It's from the 27-yard line, so it's a 37-yard field goal attempt. The ball is in the air, and it's good. Another 3 points for Team Canada, who take the lead, who's still in the lead, 24-10. And 2 seconds and 7 tenths still to go in this first half. So we will see a kickoff and a return. If we see a return, but we will see at least a kick. Kickoff, Team Canada, and it's a squib kick taken by a Frenchman, number 1, and he tries to return the ball, but there are too many hunters, and he is the rabbit, and now he's down. So, first half is over. Canada 24-10 against the French team. They really struggled in the first quarter with this French team, and they found their rhythm in the second quarter and scored touchdowns and a field goal now. And the lead is okay now, and it looks like Team Canada is in a good way now in this tournament. We'll be back in about 15 minutes with the second half. Please stay tuned. Okay, I just see it's 20 minutes is the break here. So we will be back in 15, 20 minutes, okay? Thank you very much for listening. And once again, I have to say it. I don't have to say my mother language. I have to say it's my native language is German. And I just decided to switch into English now because I found out many listeners from Canada are online. And so maybe before I tell you take some German lessons, I try to remember what I learned in school about English. See you in 50 minutes. Bye-bye.
komm schon mit meinen Kandidaten und mit dem Jack Girl auf das Spielfeld. Zu gewinnen gibt es den Original Stack aus den USA. Herzhaftes, luftgetrocknetes Rindfleisch, eine Monatsration gibt es zu gewinnen. Und für alle Sportler unter den Zuschauern, viel Protein, Kalorien haben maximal 4% Fett. Wir beginnen mit dem Kick von der 10-Yard-Linie. Und wer es schafft, hier kurz zu treffen, oder wenn es mehrere schaffen, ein 20-Yard-Field-Goal zu schießen, dann gehen wir 10 Yards zurück, so lange bis nur noch ein Kandidat übrig bleibt. Neben mir eine hübsche Frau mit der Monatsration herzhaftes Rindfleisch. So, nur eines noch vorweg. Also ich bin jetzt das erste Mal wieder unterm Spielfeld und ich sehe, welche beeindruckende Kulisse das für die Spieler der einzelnen Nationen sein muss, mit diesen gefüllten Rängen. Also einen riesen Applaus mal für das Publikum und recht herzlichen Dank vom Organisationskomitee für euch. So, der erste Kandidat schon bei mir, hast du schon mal gekickt? Was heißt teilweise den Ball nicht getroffen oder nur zugeschaut? Okay, das sind die Voraussetzungen für dich, du bist da. Mario, ich hätte gesagt, dein Kommando. So, und das Publikum natürlich unterstützt den Mario. Wie beim Kickoff. Jawohl, wir feuern den Mario an. Der Mario sollte noch jemanden retten, wandert mit dem nächsten Kick zur 20-Yard-Linie. Als nächstes eine Dame. Du bist die. Hast du schon mal gekickt?
Ja.
Auch mit einem roten Ball. Okay, und jetzt werden wir mal schauen. Dein Schuhwerk ist nämlich sehr interessant und da bin ich jetzt gespannt, ob sich die Schuhe weiter fliegen als der Ball. Also, wir unterstützen den nächsten, die nächste Kandidatin.
Uiuiui. Ganz knapp, ganz knapp, bitte. Hey, wie ist sie da reingekommen? Ich bin schon vor, dass du mit der Golfhose auch verschießt.
Okay, ich denke, das war das Schuhwerk. Was sagst du? Perfekt. Der nächste im Jack Links Kicking Contest. Du bist da? Didi, Kicking Erfahrung? Gar keine? Das sollte reichen. Der nächste Fußballer, der Didi, mit dem Feed-Goal-Versuch beim Jack Links Meat Snack Kicking Contest. Und jetzt fangen wir an. Ausgetroffen. Das heißt, wir haben zumindest mal zwei Kandidaten für die 20-Yard-Linie. Die nächste Kandidatin auch wieder mit perfekten Schuhwerk fürs Kicken. Hallo Steffi, was schätzt du? Deine Schuhe jetzt? Bleiben die am Fuß oder?
Ja, ist alleine letzter Mixplatz.
Ja, natürlich.
Probier mal. Ich sag mal, die Schuhe ausziehen, um Gottes
Willen! Ausziehen, 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 ausziehen,
ausziehen, ausziehen!
So, und jetzt einen riesen Applaus und der Feuermann, die Steffi!
Komisch!
Ja, sind sie ja, die muss nicht ausziehen. Das Publikum fordert eine Zugabe. Das können wir noch nachholen. Und der letzte Aircheck Links Kicking Contest. Der Linky. Hast du schon mal gekickt oder Kicking Erfahrung? Okay, dann schauen wir mal. Zumindest passt das Schuhwerk. zu wenig Rückenlage, hätte ich da jetzt gesagt. Also mehr Konzentration jetzt beim Didi.
Der zweite war sowieso besser.
Zumindest hat er ein Football-Jersey an. So, jetzt klatscht mal den Didi ein.
Football-Jersey.
Didi hat gewonnen und zwar eine schlechte Name. Nein, nicht die Filiana neben mir, die Promotion-Name von Jack Fries ist, sondern das sogenannte Jack Fries.
Wahrscheinlich ist es sehr gescheiter, du gewinnst das Fleisch nicht.
Beinahe lebensgroß, Didi.
Der Bob auf Scheller ist schon geil.
So, einen riesen Applaus für unsere Kandidaten, für die Steffi, die Sandra, Mario, Niki und unseren Sieger, den Didi. Wir bedanken uns bei unserem Sponsor Jack Mills, dass er diesen Kicking-Contest möglich gemacht hat mit den Original Snacks aus den USA. Die Protein- und Kalorienarm von maximal 4% Fett für dich, Didi. Und du verlierst schon das halbe. Also, ich wünsche euch noch viel Spaß.
Welcome back here in the UPC Arena in Graz, in the heart of Europe. Second half between Canada and Team France is coming up. The Canadians lead here 24-10, and we have some statistics from the first half. We have first downs for Canada 14, France only 7.5 of this. Rushing yards, Canada 116, France 21. Passing yards, Canada 158, France 88. Quarterback Foltz was rushing for one time for 57 yards and a touchdown. This was the first touchdown in the game, and he was passing for 20 times, completing 14 passes for 158 yards and one touchdown. He also was picked once. Quarterback Max Breuil from Team France was attempting 17 times and completed 8 passes for 88 yards, one touchdown, no pick. And he's also the leading rusher with one attempt for 10 yards, because Kinnard, the second rusher, had four attempts, also for 10 yards. Receiving Wahlberg on the side of Canada with 4 catches for 44 yards. Also Murray with 4 catches for 37 yards. And Chambers catches the ball 3 times for 52 yards. The side of France, Durand for 22 yards, caught the ball twice. Also 2 catches, Kinnard for 15 yards. So not much there with the offense. It started really good in the first quarter for the French, but then they fell back. And Canada take the momentum and, yeah, just played them out. They knocked them out, they coached them out, they rushed them out, and they tackled them out. Now we hear Electric Light Orchestra in the background. That reminds me of a film I saw last week. Anybody seen Super 8? New movie by J.J. Abrams, produced by Steven E.T. Spielberg. Movie is very good to the very end. At the end, it's again Spielberg. But if you haven't seen the movie, I'm not going to spoil it. Go in the cinemas, look at it. It's much fun. A little bit 80s feeling if you're like me, 40 plus. Let us say 30 plus. It's really a lot of fun to watch this. Super 8. And that was our advertisement for this day. So we'll have a kickoff of Team Canada. Team France will receive the ball in the second half for the first team. Kickoff Canada, Lirim, second name, doesn't matter, is kicking off. We have two men on the return team French, and they return it from the end zone, number 84, and he's on the 25-yard line. He gets stopped, good return, 27 yards return by Frenchman. Yeah. He's not on my roster. Do you have 84 on your roster? No. Guy which we don't have on the roster. So this is actually not the game day roster that we have here now. It's the France senior national team roster. And I think they switched some numbers before kickoff. Doesn't matter. Return was to the 25-yard line from -2. And we have a first down for Team French, and it's a play action fake. Faked handover and a rush for about 4 or 5 yards. Did I say faked handover? Damn, that will be funny. A handoff fake. Brings it second down and 7 to go. It was for 3 yards. Ball is spotted back for 1 yard. Number 47 is in motion. Sproel in the shotgun. Now we have two tight ends for Team Canada, Team France. They're trying to rush through the middle with a good effort. Number 28 rushing for 5 yards. That's Laurent Marcelin from Flash de la Courneuve in the beautiful city of Paris. It's a third down and still two to go for Team France. Sproel sends his 81 in motion. We have a flag. I think it's an illegal motion because two men were moving. Or they call it a false start. I don't know. Let's see what the white cap is saying. Yeah, it's a false start, Team Canada. He said that's crap. It's Team France. He said Team Canada, didn't he? No, it's Team France. It's not right. There is no possibility for Team Canada at the moment to make a false start. They are on the, with their defense on the field. So we have a third down and 7 to go. Kind of a wishbone formation now. Number one gets in motion and we have a complete pass, but an early stop by number 55 with a huge tackle, Peter Carrière. And so it's a fourth down and 5 to go for the French, and they will have to punt the ball away once again. So the second half started as the first ended, with the French offense who is not able to move the ball anymore. Number one punts the ball and it's downed by number 44 by the French, Thomas Mimouni. And Team Canada is taking over. Get the ball back at their own 43-yard line. So the stadium's announcer is asking where the Canadian fans are, and the about 5,000 people who are in the stadium here are all on the Canadian side. Some of them are on the, for the French team, but I think that's the hockey bonus because everybody in Austria loves the Canadian hockey team, so they also love the Canadian football team. And we have a huge tackle. It's a quarterback sack. No, it's a quarterback sack by number 51 of the French team, Anthony Charon, for a huge loss for 8 yards, brings up second down and 18 to go. So maybe, I think it's the ice hockey team that the Austrians here like, Canada, more than the French. We love ice hockey. It's ice hockey here, it's hockey in Canada, we know, because we also play hockey without ice here, you know. And a complete pass to number 11. Michael Foltz passes the ball to Alexandre Beurier for another Canada first down in the half of the French team already. Exactly on the 42-yard line of Team France, Canada gets a fresh set of downs. Michael Foltz in the shotgun is going to pass it away to number 86, but he couldn't hold on to the ball. Incomplete pass, good defense, by the way, by number 3, Arnaud Vidalier from the Spartiates, Damien. Thank you. Second down and 10 to go for Canada. Again, a pass complete to number 82. And he tries to break the tackles of the French team, but he's down for a first down. Jet Gardiner. And there is a late flag, and I think it's again on sportsmanlike conduct. Let's see what the Whitecap is saying. We have a French player on his knees.
After the play, it's sportsmanlike conduct. Canada number 68, 15 yards.
It's against Zachary Bollari on sportsmanlike conduct. So that brings a first down, but 15 yards behind. And number 90 of the French team is injured, and I think it has something to do with this unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. David La Rochelle from the Cougars, the Saint-Quentin Leon Meunier. I don't think that's right spelled. As I mentioned, my native language is German, and also French is not my favorite language. Actually, I can't say only ugly things or things which have to do with sex, and nobody wants to hear that, I guess. So, first down and 10, Canada on their 42-yard line, and we have a rush through the middle for 2 yards. Second and 8. Second down and 7. Faltz handles over the ball to his running back, who is stopped immediately after the handover. And it's a loss for a yard. 3rd and 9, Canada. It's a good crowd here. We have the game Austria against Japan, which was, of course, the game with the most people here on the stands. We had 6,500 paying. I guess it's something like 8,000 in here with all the VIPs and other guys. And we have a deep pass intended for the number 84, and there are a lot of flags there. And it looks like to me it was a pass interference by the French defenders. Number 25, I guess, made the pass interference. It should be Tony Rajapin. The referees are still debating. Now Whitecap is talking to us. Wow. It's a pass interference against Team Canada. Against. No, we have two flags on the play. Penalties are offset, and so it brings up a third down. Yeah, it's the, we replay this down. 3rd down and 9. Michael Faltz with the pass complete to number 34 for another first down for Team Canada. Nick Fitzgibbon caught the ball. University of Guelph. First and 10, Canada on the 30-yard line of the French team. Hand over to the running back, and he takes up a couple of yards. Second and 8 coming up. 5 minutes, 30 seconds still to play in the third quarter. No points in the second half. Yet, still the lead for Team Canada, 24. French team, 10 points. Second and eight. Again, a rush through the middle. Number 34 takes the ball and carries it about 4 or 5 yards. Nick Fitzgibbon. Ball comes up now to a third down and four to go for Canada. And again, a rush. And it's good for a first down. What Nick Fitzgibbon is doing here. We have Laola in the stadium. The wave. Yeah, really a great crowd here in the stadium. A little bit a surprise for me because I thought everybody will go home after the game of the Austrians against Japan. At least they lost the game also, and I thought, okay, everybody will be in a bad mood and go home. No, they didn't do it. They are here for the World Championships, and I guess there are still 5,000 here in the stadium. First down for the Canadians in the red zone of Team France, and again, a good run through the middle for Canada. And we have an injured player of Team France on the field. That is up again, number 5. Got a hit. Julian Supardi. Yeah, the whole stadium is singing now. It's really fun to be here. But we have still a football game, guys, down there. There's another party zone, yes, after the game. Second down and four to go. Number 33 on the carry, and he had got some room on the left side, and he got tackled on the 2 yard line, brought down. Matt Walters, I really like this guy. He's really playing good, he's quick. Good moves, and a strong guy too. A real running back for Team Canada, and he brings a first and goal for Canada on the 2 yard line of the French team. First and goal, and a sneak, but it wasn't good for a touchdown. Still a yard to go. Second and goal on the 1 yard line. Michael Foltz on the center, sneaks again, and there is a flag. There's a flag down, and touchdown signal is there, but a flag is also there. What's the flag for?
Offside, Team France, Dominic Team France, touchdown.
It's a penalty against the French, and it's a touchdown by quarterback Michael Foltz, a 1 yard sneak play, and it brings a 30-10 lead for Canada for the extra point. Extra point is also good, 31-10. The lead for Team Canada now. Still 2 minutes and 13 seconds left to play in the third quarter. Let's see if the French offense can come back in this game. Doesn't look too good since the second quarter. So as I can see, we have many listeners who don't know where who we are and where we are. We are located in Vienna, Austria. We are football-austria.com. You find all the stats, all photos and videos, interviews on football-austria.com. Also from this game and all other games from the World Championships. A good return by the French team to the 27-yard line. You can also find us on Twitter. It's Football Austria. And you can find us on Facebook. It's facebook.com/American football. I see the people now want to party, not to watch this game anymore. A lot of disco, old disco hits here played by the DJ. And yeah, we have still a game here, and we have an early flag before the snap. Looks like a false start by the French team. And a false start it is. It's a first down and 15 to go for Team France. Wow, not a good run by number 28 by the French team. It's a first down and 15 yards more. Big play by number 28, whose name is Laurent Marceline, from the French record champion Flash de la Courneuve. Great play now. Ball is spotted on the 46-yard line. And we have a quick slant pass by Max Brody to his receiver Jeremy Rabot. Second down and 6 to go for the French team. And Marceline is on the carry again, this time just for a couple of yards. Third down and 6 to go for the French team.
Awesome.
And we have again a complete pass for a first down for Team France. And it's again Laurent Marcelino now takes the responsibility. No, I'm sorry, a correction. It was number 22, Dimitri Kernard, who caught the ball. But suddenly the French team is awake again. Another pass and it's almost picked. 25, almost picked the pass of Max Breuer, and number 25 is Joel Lipinski. Lipinski sounds to me like an Austrian, but he is a Canadian. But there is also... No, it's not a flag. Just a reflection. Now we have some weird animations by the advertisement, which is lightened from behind. I think you can see it on the webcam. And we have some reflections on the field, which are really disturbing, actually. But that's the price for the big show, huh? Isn't it? Number 47 in motion, goes on the right side of the tight end position. Number 28, Laurent Marcelin, takes the ball and carries it about a half a yard. And time is running down, and it brings us to the fourth quarter of this game. Still the lead for Canada, 31-10. Last quarter of the last game on day two of the IFOF World Championships in American football. Tomorrow, Group A in Innsbruck is playing again. Germany is playing there. Against the USA, and before we see Mexico against Australia, there will be a live ticker from the Germany-USA game here. I think there will be nothing for the Mexican-Australian game. Eurosport is broadcasting the German game on 10 p.m. Central Europe time. That means as live, not live. And there will be a live ticker on Football Austria for this game. Only a ticker, no audio there. Meanwhile, Team France is on a third down and 16 to go. And an incomplete pass. So we have fourth down and 14 to go while the attenders here are cheering because the cheerleader of the Graz Giants, the home team here in Graz, come out. Fourth down and 15 to go. Punt formation, Team France. Bunt is in the air and looks very good. Downed by number 22 on the 5-yard line, Dimitri Kernard. Now, ball is spotted on the 9-yard line. There he made the catch. First down, Team Canada at their own 9-yard line. A good rush now for another first down for Canada. Number 34, Nick Fritz Gibbon, with the first down for Canada to their own 22-yard line. Another run by Fitzgibbon. Breaks a tackle and a second one and carries the ball about 7 yards. Really looks good now what the Canadian offense is doing in the second half and in the second quarter. At the beginning of the game, it really looks like they struggled. They had to find their rhythm, but finally they found it. Now Team French is most of the time with their defense on the field, which means they get tired. And another rush by Fitzgibbon. This time for no gain or maybe a yard. Canada is rushing the ball, just trying to control the game clock and bring this to an end. Third down and two, Canada. Another run by Fitzgibbon. And another first down for Canada. Nick Fitzgibbon, now the go-to guy in this early fourth quarter for Team Canada, who seem that they don't want to pass the ball anymore. Why should they? Rushing game is good, is working for them, and it kills the clock too. Screen pass to number 84. Shamot Chambers with a catch. We have some discussions on the field by the referees. The catch was complete, wasn't it, Christoph? And what are they discussing about? What is this discussion about? They give it an incomplete pass. What? No. Spot the ball at the 41, but the down marker is still at the 34. So now he's moving. Okay, don't know what that was about. It's a second down and two to go for Canada. And Fitzgibbon is on the carry again. Looks like another first down for Canada. Thank you. New first down for Canada on their own 44. We have a new quarterback for Canada now on the field. This is Josh Sacoby from Ottawa. And we have a false start for Team Canada. Wow, a complete pass by the new quarterback, Josh Sacoby, to his receiver, number 18, Tante Luciani. First down for Team Canada on the 45 yard line of France. Another pass, this one goes deep, and it's complete to number 82, and he's not in for a touchdown, but almost in. Chet Gardinier. It's a first down and goal. Ball is spotted on the 2 yard line of Team France. And it's an incomplete pass dropped by the receiver in the end zone. I can't see his number right now. It's 32. Second down and goal. And there was a movement, Canadians say, as there is a flag down before the snap. Yeah, but it's against Canada. People recognize me right here. I'm on Austrian TV sometimes, and now people recognize that I'm sitting here talking English, and everybody's wondering what I'm doing. Second down and goal for Canada, and another carry by Fitzgibbon, but there is no touchdown signal yet. We have a third down and goal on the 6 yard line. So this must be confusing for some people here, because they see me presenting the NFL on Austrian TV, and of course we are commentating in German, and now they see me sitting here in front of a MacBook and talking English to somebody that they can't see, and they're confused and they're drunk, and being confused and being drunk together is sometimes really hard, but this is a man's world. Quick pass on the right side, and now we're in or not. Yes, we're in for another Canada touchdown. Woohoo! Number 32 makes the catch and goes in the end zone. No, it's 33, I guess, because there is no 32 under us. The 33, Matt Walters with the catch and the next touchdown for Canada. 37-10 for the Maple Leafs. Extra point is good, 38-10. So this looks very, very clear for Team Canada, 38-10. As we remember, beginning of the second quarter, it was 10-7 for Canada and this for France, and that looked really good for the French team at that moment. And then the whole thing really turned around for Team Canada, and now they're. Yeah, they are the better team, and they really deserved to win this game here. Well coached, good rushing game, good quarterbacks, and a great defense. And a great kicker who kicks the ball now through the end zone. It's a touchback, and the French will start on their own 20. First play, the French rush for a yard. Quick pass to number 18, but he lost the ball, and the referee says it's an incomplete pass. But I guess it was another decision where we can talk about it. Looks to me like a fumble. So it's a 3rd and 9 for France. Another pass and complete to number 4, but not a first down. So the French have to punt the ball away once again. Steve Delaval caught this ball. 4th down and 7 to go. No way for the French team to gain here yards, and the defense of the Canadian team adjusted in the second quarter. And now they really control this game. Punt is good, and it's on the 38 line, and number 21 breaks two tackles and is on his way, is on the 20 and is on the 12 yard line. What an effort by number 21. It's Troy Adams with a huge return from the Canadian 40 yard line to the French 14 yard line. And he broke two tackles and the French team really didn't look good. It's special teams where Canada is also dominating this game. Great return. Troy Adams, Northwestern State University. Guess this is in Canada. There's a Northwestern State University, I guess also in the US. Don't know if he's from the USA. And the crowd is cheering for another Canada touchdown. One guy now in the stadium is very lonely, is Vince Lillard. He's the ex-quarterback of the French team. And he was the offense coordinator for the Vienna Vikings for 2 years. And now he is a receiver and living in Vienna for some time with the Vienna Knights. And he's here today cheering for his French team, and this is a late hit, a bad late hit by the French team. Now hits the receiver into the advertising bar, which is it's the third quarterback I heard just on the field, Christoph Wagner, who is ticking the game below me. If you're on Football Austria, you can also see the live ticker with play-by-play. And it's the third quarterback, and it's a really bad penalty now for the French team, because that was a monster late hit against the advertisement here. A little bit like arena football when I watch it, because it's just 4 meters away. It's like 3 yards and 66 and 6 feet or something like that. It should be away, and I think it's too close. Number 10 gets the ball, and he's brought down immediately. It was a quarterback sack, because it's the third quarterback in the game. Donnie Marshall now from the University of Western Ontario. Now the quarterback for Team Canada, who switched two times. Starting quarterback was Michael Foltz, then on the third quarter played Josh Sacobi, and now is Donnie Marshall, who is under center. Actually, he is in the shotgun formation at the moment. And he again tries to do it by himself, and again, there is no way for him to gain yards. Funny story about the Canadian team. When they fly to Graz, they had to stop in Paris, and when they get into the plane again, they suddenly found out that one linebacker is missing. They didn't tell us what the name of the linebacker is, but he was still on the airport, and he had to take the next flight and came back to Graz then. But yes, it's a pass in the end zone, and it's caught. And it's a touchdown, another touchdown by Team Canada. This time it's number 84 who made the catch. Shamot Chambers caught an 8-yard pass from Tony Marshall. 44-10. Yeah, the linebacker is here now, and it doesn't look like that this missing person for one day confused the Canadian team in any way. Maybe in the first quarter. But now they are really on their way to play the role they were supposed to. One of the favorites here in this tournament. Kick is also good. Wow, 44-10 the lead for Canada against vice European champion France.
Distanz zwischen den beiden Mannschaften, also das zeigt schon ganz deutlich, dass Kräfteverhältnis
That's 45 points, of course, for Canada and 10 for the French team. Two minutes and 9 seconds still to play here. We have a new kicker here. What is his number? No, it's again Lirim Ajahula with a kickoff. And the play was whistled before the return. Referee said the receiver was down with his knee. Didn't see that. No, he made a fair catch signal. And he said, no, it didn't make a fair catch signal. Actually, it makes no sense because he was alone there. And there was no... Yeah, they said he made a fair catch signal. I didn't see that. And seems to me very unusual to make a fair catch signal when there is no need to. But the referees decided it that way, and so the French team has to start at their own 6-yard line. Safety, danger. With this defense on the other side, you really have to take care now. Not to get another 2 points. Rush through the middle, is out of the end zone, and brings up a second down and still 10 to go. Second down and 9 to go. The French with the back against the wall. Another rush through the middle. Good one with broke two tackles. Laurent Marcelin. And now they're out of the danger zone. With a new... No, it's not a first down. It's a third down and 2 to go for the French team. It's just 40 seconds to go. Third down and 3 to go for the French team. And I don't think that they get a first down here. But the clock is ticking down, and I guess that was it. I don't think that anyone is going to take a timeout now. It's a fourth down and 1 yard to go. There will be no play anymore in this game. The clock is down at 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and the game is over. Canada wins here in Group B, 45-10 against their team France, and yeah, will be the next opponent of Team Austria. And it's what we saw, very, very strong team, good special teams, good rushing game, good quarterbacks, good passing game, and a great defense. I don't saw any weakness there. Just in the first quarter they were a little bit confused because it's what their first game, but then the motor went on, and when the motor was started, the engine was started, the machine was really, really well oiled and running. So thanks for listening. We will tell you who are the most valuable players are. There will be a MVP on both sides in every game. The game MVP for France and the game MVP for Team Canada. Let's see who this is. Side MVP is quarterback Michael Foltz. And the French MVP is Dimitri Kirnan, the MVP for the French team, the running back, number 22. So this was it from our side. Hope you enjoyed this. You find all pictures, photos, videos, stats on Football Austria during this night. We're going to work in the hotel the whole night through for you. And tomorrow, Group A is on. And we will have a live ticker from the game Germany versus the US of A. There will be no live stream there, and there will be no broadcasting there. Broadcasting again on Group B here. You can watch the games on ORF. It's ORF.at. They also have a live stream, so you can watch these games. Some of them are also online. And you can watch games of the Group A at Eurosport.com. or eurosportplayer.de. It's D like David and E like Angie. See you maybe next time. My name is, still is, Walter Reiterer. I'm from Football Austria and say thank you and good night, guys.